purpose of this short video is to assist you in creating ADA compliant tables. Let's get started. The first thing that I'd like to mention is that the table title is above the table. And the reason for that is because anytime that you merge cells in a table, it's not ADA compliant. So typically what we like to do is place the title in the first row and merge the first row. However, if you do that, your table will not be compliant. So what you can do is place your title directly above and go in and maybe make it bold or center it, and that will still look nice. It still identifies your table and it's ADA compliant. The next thing that I'd like to double check with you on compliance for tables is I'd like to take a look at the properties and do the title and the alt text. So this little square here will select my whole table. I can click it or unclick it, and it'll select my whole table. When I select my table, I get my table tools, design and layout. I'm going to click the layout tab. On the layout tab, you can see they've made it much easier for us to make tables ADA compliant because it's extremely important. If I come over here to my layout tab, in my table grouping, I see my properties. Previous to this, in order to get that, I'd have to right-click and go to table properties. But now they've made it easy for us. Under my table properties, I can go to my alt text tab and enter my title and type my description, and that will be complete. However, we can't stop there. We also have to make sure that we repeat our header rows. Now, you have to identify what row or rows will be your header rows. And I'm going to kind of explain this as we go. So hang in there with me. This would be my header row because it's got my identifiers on it. Body part, standard stick figure, and enhanced stick figure. So I'm going to select just this row. And I'm going to go back up to this layout tab. And on the far right, under my data grouping, I can select here, repeat header rows. Now, if I don't want to do it there, I could go back old school where I used to go and right click and go under table properties. And then I could go under my rows and check this box, which is already checked because I just did it by selecting here, which is repeat header row at the top of each page. All right, I'm going to say okay because I've completed that task. Now, what does that actually mean? Well, a table is read top to bottom and left to right. So it actually repeats the header row as it goes and reads the table out to the user. So for us who don't have any visual issues, it's kind of nice because when you get to the next page, look at what happens. It re-identifies your headers for you as you get to page 2 and page 3 and so on. So what it does for us is creates the header on the next page. But what it does for someone who's using this as a reader is it actually reads body part, arms, standard stick figure, yes, enhanced stick figure, yes, body part, legs, standard stick figure, yes, enhanced stick figure, yes, body part, hands, standard stick figure, no, enhanced stick figure, yes. So do you see that process of going top to bottom and left to right? And it will continuously repeat this so that the person who's listening to the audio does not forget what the column identifier is. Also, let me mention to you that you really cannot have any blank cells. So this here would not be ADA compliant. I would need to remove all these blank cells in order for it to be ADA compliant. So I could delete those. And I would also need to delete this row here. All right, so now this table here is ADA compliant. I've got my title and my description. I didn't really type them in, but you know how to get to them now. And I repeated my header rows. I have only text in my table. I don't have images, and I don't have any merged cells. So my table is ADA compliant. Good luck as you create your tables and make them ADA compliant.